The number of foreign students starting their first university semester in Germany decreased by 21% from 2019 to 2020. But is it not possible to come to Germany anymore in those circumstances? Is it too dangerous, or is it just not worth to start to study at the moment? All those questions we will discuss in this video. Hallo und herzlich willkommen to My Road to Germany, the channel you should subscribe when you want to move, study, work and live here in Germany. My name is Sebastian Schirmer and in this video we will discuss the actual situation regarding COVID and the global pandemic and answer the question if it's still worth for you to come and start your studies here in Germany. And to answer these questions, we will ask more questions from different aspects that will give you a good overview and that will help you to find your personal answer to the question if you should come or not. And for that, I prepared a little structure. The first point I want to speak about with you is if it's even possible to come to Germany at the moment. The second point we will discuss is how the university is going on at the moment, how students' lives look like. What will bring us to the third point that I want to speak about with you, and it's the social life. So how social life is at the moment in Germany, how the restrictions look like, how they affect you in your daily life here, and what that means for you as you're starting your studies. The fourth point will be then about the healthcare situation here in Germany. Is it dangerous regarding Corona? Because you maybe ask yourself the question if you should travel in those times, if you should take that risk and come here to Germany. And we will close the topic with the fifth point, where we'll speak about finance and finding a job, because I think that's another really important aspect. If you're coming from abroad or in general start to study here, you need to finance yourself, you need maybe to earn your costs of living. All of those points will lead us to a summary at the end, and I will give you my personal opinion if I would recommend you to come here to Germany at the moment or not. So the first question or the point that we will answer is it still possible to come to Germany for students' purposes, so with a student's visa? And in short words, yes, it is. So whether you are an exchange student or a long-term student, you can come to Germany. Of course, you need to have the acceptance of a German university, you need to have your visa as regularly, you need to apply for your visa, or it depends from which country you're coming, but in general, you need to apply for a visa and you need to fulfill the requirements to get one. But if you do so, you can still come. There are entry restrictions to Germany, but you, if you are a student, you are an exception. You can also watch about this, my other video about the entry restrictions to Germany at the moment and what you should think about if you want to come here. So there are only two little points that you need to have in your mind additionally to normal times. And the first one is that your university needs to give you a paper where they prove that it's really necessary for you to come to Germany. So they need to give you a paper where it's written, here it is necessary, our studies requires the persons or the people to be here, that you are not able to do the studies from your home country. And maybe you ask yourself now, but yeah, I mean, the studies are online at the moment, they are digital on the university that I've applied. That doesn't really matter. We also experienced that as my girlfriend Carla also just have digital semesters or digital courses, and she got a paper like this from the university, so she was able to come from Mexico to Germany. So just ask your university and I think you will have really, really good chances to get one. And I mean, that's also fair, because in some countries you just have time gap, or the time differences is so big that you would have to work in the night or to appear at lectures in the night. So it's just really difficult. And the second point is, please check the German embassy in your country, and in general, be aware that the process might take longer than usually. We also experienced that as my girlfriend Carla was able to apply for a visa by law, by the rules of German, but the German embassy in Mexico was closed for 9 months. So practically she was not able to apply because there were not proceeding students visa, they were just proceeding visas for family purposes that were valued higher, what is also okay. But I just want to give you with that the information that check that also, because the one thing is what is written somewhere and the other thing is the reality. As I know so far, in most of the countries, the German embassies are working and you can now get your student's visa again. In some countries, you don't even need to apply for a visa in your country. You are doing that when you are in Germany, but for most of the countries, that counts. Second point, or the second question I want to speak about with you, is how the university looks like at the moment. And as in probably most of the other countries of the world, most of the lectures, lessons and courses are held online or digital. That means you're not meeting the other students in presence, but you're meeting them through Zoom, through Teams and other web applications, and the professors are having their lectures there. And the quality of those lectures highly depends on the university, but especially on the professor. So as in your normal offline studies, there are professors that are super motivated. So those are the professors that are using the latest technical tools to make the lessons really engaging, to make it good and cool for you so that you learn a lot. But there are also professors that just upload their PowerPoint slides and then they talk 3 hours in front of your computer about a topic that is more or less interesting for you. So that really depends, and it's not really easy to give a general answer regarding that. Of course, that also depends on your personal preferences and about them and how they affect your session. I will talk a little bit later on. When it comes to exams, also them are most of the time digital or online. So maybe you have group works or you have more academic papers than usually that you have to hand in, because there are less written exams. So the professors or the universities, depends on the subject, try to find a way to be able to offer you kind of an exam, but maybe in another form that you were used to in the past, at least here in Germany. I've also heard from many friends that it's somehow easier, so that the professors are not that strict when it comes to the exams, which is maybe also important for you. But on the other side, if we look to studies, we see that 72% of all students in Germany say that the workload got higher in those digital semesters. And this leads us to the question what you personally prefer. Maybe we can discuss about that in the topic and have a little conversation. What is the better form of studies? But I think to help you to understand the situation here, it's also nice to know what the students in German say about the actual situations, because there were a few surveys that ask students how they feel and what they think about those digital way of learning. And we have to say that 60% of all the students that were asked said that they are feeling bad or really bad when they are thinking about to have another digital semester. But also 20% said they are feeling good or really good, so they would prefer that, while 60% would prefer an offline semester, and 20% for them it didn't really matter if it's offline or online, everything is fine. And to give you an even better understanding of what it means to study online, I also want to show you the 3 most frequently given advantages and the 3 mostly named disadvantages by German students when it comes to online studies versus offline studies. And the 3 advantages that they named were, first, more flexibility, what is kind of clear because you can work wherever you want, you can visit a friend in Stuttgart, even you are studying in Berlin, and you can attend the classes from there. The second advantage is that you don't have to go to the university anymore, so that means you are saving time, because sometimes that can be really annoying if you just have 2 lessons or 2 hours of lessons on one day and you need half an hour to get to the university and you need half an hour to get back. So that's what students also like regarding those digital lessons. The third point is that you're getting more used to digital tools, what also many students see as an advantage. On the other side, we have the 3 most frequently named negative effects on those online studies. And the first one is, of course, no direct contact to other students. So it's definitely a negative point, and it's a little bit more difficult to meet new people, because normally you're having this somehow naturally. You just go to university, you connect with other students, you communicate with them, and that is not given at the moment, of course, you can also meet online, but it's probably not the same. The second negative aspect that students named was that you have to do even more by your own. Because normally, you're maybe not really motivated on one day, but you just go to university, you see the other students learning there, you see them in the library, you do something together, and now this is even more on your own. So some students maybe can't motivate themselves so much on their own because they have to coordinate everything by themselves. And the third point, also coming together with that, is that it's not so easy to combine your private life and your student's life anymore, because there is no really barrier or there is no separation between those two. That means you are maybe attending the lessons, the lectures in the same place where you are eating, where you are sleeping, if you just have like one room. And for some students, that is just not the way how they want to manage it. So what we know so far is that some students said that they prefer online classes. Some said, or the majority said, that they do not prefer online classes. They would prefer to have offline or normal university lectures where they can meet other students. What also leads us to the next point, and that is the social life as a student in Germany at the moment. So how is the student's life in Germany at the moment? Of course, as almost everywhere, we have restrictions regarding COVID and the global pandemic here in Germany. So it's not as it was 2 or 3 years before. That means sports clubs are closed, the gyms are closed, restaurants are closed. You can order food for takeaway, but you cannot go there. Bars are closed, clubs are not open. So to sum up, many activities that you were used to do or that people like to do are just not allowed or not possible to do them at the moment. And with that, as we already said, the university is also closed. So of course, it is a little bit more difficult to make friends and to get in contact with new people at the moment. Of course, you can organize something by your own or by yourself. You can invite people to your home to cook there. You can go out with them for a coffee walk, but also you're not allowed to meet in bigger groups. So also that is restricted. I think that in the next months, at least in summer, that is going to be better and things are going to open. You will be able to go to a restaurant and sit outside there. But at the moment, that is not the case. And that all depends how COVID is developing here in Germany. So especially for you, as you're coming from another country, that is important to keep in mind. Yeah, it is more difficult to get in contact with other people at the moment. And life is just somehow more boring. But to evaluate if that should be really a reason not to come here, I think we need to dive a little bit deeper. First of all, I think you should ask yourself regarding that, what is your purpose of moving to Germany and to study here? Is it you want to have a good time abroad and you want to party and living somehow the student's life? Then, of course, the biggest purpose is somehow not accessible anymore as clubs, bars and so on are closed. So if that is your main purpose of coming here, I cannot recommend you to come here, at least not at the moment. But if you want to come here because you want to learn German, or you want to build up your further life here, or you want to have cheap, good qualification, then it's maybe another thing. So you should really think about, why do you want to come and study here? I would say, if it's one of those purposes, it is still recommendable to come. The next important point you should ask yourself is which person you are. That means, are you really outgoing? Do you need a lot of social contact? Or are you a little bit more introverted? Because I think especially when you're more introverted, it is a little bit more difficult at the moment to make friends or to get to know people here. If you're more outgoing, I think it's easier for you to also text randomly people or to download an app and to meet with someone outside that you maybe don't know so well. But if you're a little bit more introverted and it's maybe difficult for you to make new contacts in general or to make the first step, I can recommend you rent yourself a shared flat so you already live with other people together, and this directly brings you into social groups, that brings you into contact. You have someone with who you can communicate when you are at home. So this will really help you for your start. So that is highly recommendable in my eyes, in my opinion, especially in the moment. And I think that's the same for almost everyone around the world. And the last, and for me the most important aspect of this social life, or in general the life in Germany here at the moment, is what is your alternative? Do you want to cancel your goal to come to study here in Germany and want to do something else instead, like work in your home country? Then ask yourself, is that really a good situation at the moment to start a full-time job? Because maybe the economically situation in your home country is also not the best due to the corona crisis. Or you maybe think about to postpone your studies, but who is able to tell you when everything will change again? So really, really think about your alternatives and also look on your home countries and your alternative. How is the life here? How is it in Germany? Because yeah, you're not allowed to go to a nightclub here at the moment, but probably you're also not allowed to go in a nightclub in your home country. So in my opinion, you should still come to Germany when you have the goal to start your studies here. The fourth point is Corona and the health system here in Germany, and if it's safe to come here or if you need to also consider this aspect. And to make it short, I think you really don't have to worry about this because Germany has one of the best healthcare systems in the whole world. Even within Europe, Germany is on the top. And why am I saying this? Especially when we are looking at Corona, it is important how many high intensity beds where you can give the oxygen to people you have per 100,000 inhabitants. And in Germany, it's the highest rate. So we have almost 40 beds per 100,000 citizen of Germany, as you can also see in this graph here. And in Portugal, for example, we have 4. So Germany almost have 10 times more beds on 100,000 people than Portugal. That's why even the cases were really high in Germany at one point. We never had the problem that our hospitals were too full or that all the capacity was already used by the hospitals. It was a little bit critical, but just for specific hospitals and not for whole Germany. So really, I think if you have concerns about that, about the risk regarding health, don't worry. I think Germany is a really good place to be. Also because your health insurance that is necessary if you come here as a student and you pay for that around 100 euro per month, 110 euro, depends which one you choose, is covering everything. So if you have to go here to the hospital then because you have corona, I hope that's not the case, but if you have to do so, here everything will be covered. So I think from that perspective, you really don't need to worry. The next topic, so the fifth point I want to discuss with you is finance and job. So is it possible to find a job as a student at the moment here? And the short answer from my opinion is yes. It got a little bit more difficult as we are seeing when we look at statistics, but it's still possible. So that means while 63% of all students were in employment in 2019, in 2020 they were just 53% in employment. So that means the number of students that are having a job decreased by around 10%. In surveys, around 37% of the students says that their financial situation got worse, while 50% said it remained the same, while 11% say it got better. For those 11% of the students that said they have more money was the biggest reason because they just saved more money because they didn't went out for party or other activities. So for those 37% that had less money, the biggest reason was that they lost their job. Of course, this sounds really horrible, but we have to differentiate that a little bit further. Because you have to know that most of the students in Germany working in bars, clubs, or restaurants while they are studying. And of course, those students lost their job, at least temporarily. But there are other jobs than this, so you can just apply for a working student job in an area related to your studies. And that is also recommendable regarding your future career, because then people see that you already worked in the area that you want to work in the future. And I know many friends that find a student's job also in this time. For example, my girlfriend Carla that came here from Mexico, she had one interview and she got directly a job. So she just came here and she's already starting. Or in other words, yes, it might be a little bit more difficult, but it's still possible as many students already started a new job in a new company. But we have to differentiate that a little bit further. So you can still find a job in another area as a working student, and companies are still hiring working students because working students are cheaper compared to normal full-time employees, because it's also beneficial when it comes to the social payments that you have to do as an employer. Also, it's somehow easy and flexible to have working students, and working students are just young professionals that maybe will continue in the future in the company that they are working as a working student. So that's why companies are willing to hire working students. Regarding that, it is in general recommendable, in my opinion, for you to go to a bigger city, especially when you are not fluent in German yet, because there are more companies that are having English as their first company language, so it will be easier for you to find a job there. Also, when that is maybe not working from the beginning on, you can think about other solutions. So you can give language courses, because especially at the moment, many students or many couples also need teachers or private tutors, let's say it in that way, that help them to improve their language skills, because the schools are closed and they need someone to support them with their homework and so on. So also that can be a really good opportunity for you to start or to earn some extra money. At the end, and to answer the question of the video, or the big question of the video, if it's still worth to come to Germany, I would say yes. Because if you want to come, if that is your plan, if you want to build something up or study in Germany, you should do it now. You should not postpone or cancel it. The situation is maybe not the best in Germany here at the moment regarding Corona and what you can do, but that's also the same case in almost every place in the world. So that should not affect your plans too much, and I can still recommend you to come here. I know many people, also my girlfriend came here, and I think they don't regret it. And if you want to know more about the topic in general and other aspects of your movement to Germany, then you should subscribe to the channel and also ring the bell to not miss any video again. Thanks for watching, your Sebastian.